But here we've got two firefighters holding a fire hose, directing it at a fire. It's at steady state. They're holding the hose steady, and there's a volumetric flow rate of water. Maybe it's 200 gallons per minute. And when I say it's at steady state, it just means that it's always at 200 gallons per minute. There's nobody opening up a valve or closing a valve to change the flow rate of water. The question here now is, what is the sum of forces acting on the water, the direction that it's acting, if there is one? And it might be tempting to say that it's zero because it's at steady state. Oftentimes, if you do a free body diagram on something and it's not accelerating, you correctly assume that the sum of forces is equal to zero. However, that's not the case here. It's not zero, despite the fact that it is at steady state. When we see these types of problems, the first thing you'll do is draw what's called a control volume. So I'm going to draw that in blue, and what I'm drawing is the interior of the fire hose, so all of the water within the fire hose itself. The next thing you'll do is identify where the water enters and where it leaves the control volume. So water, the control volume, I've cut it here at the exit of the hose, so it's fairly obvious that water is leaving the exit of the hose here. What's less obvious is that water is entering our control volume right here. So our hypothetical cut of the hose, the water is entering at that location. When we look at this, you might also be inclined to say that the forces that we're talking about act to the upper left. Maybe you're imagining the hose, if the firefighters let go, the hose would tend to shoot up towards the upper left. However, that's not the force that we're talking about here. We're not talking about the force acting on the firefighter's hands. What we're talking about is the force of the firefighter's hands on the water itself. Something to think about is the rate at which momentum enters the control volume and the rate at which momentum leaves the control volume. In the bottom, we've got momentum entering the control volume, and the momentum is entirely vertical. It's only straight up and down. We've only got momentum entering in the y direction. So here I'll draw coordinate axes. Y is upward and x is to the right. So we've only got y momentum entering the control volume at the bottom. However, we have leaving the control volume, we do now have x momentum. So there's the water where it leaves the control volume, the water is going to the right and slightly upward. And because we now have x momentum leaving the control volume, there must have been a component of force acting to the right on the water. And because there's less vertical momentum leaving the control volume, there must have been a component of force acting downward. So I like to say that there is a horizontal component of force creating momentum in the x direction, and there's a component of vertical force acting in the negative y direction, which destroys the vertical component of momentum. So we're reducing the vertical component while increasing the horizontal component of momentum. So the net effect, then, if we sum those two vectors, is that the force acting on the water is to the lower right. And in fact, if we zoom in on it, we can actually see this. We can see the man's hands pushing downward and forward on the hose. This woman's hand is pushing forward in that direction, and she's also pushing downward on the hose at that location with her left hand. So the net effect of all of these forces is to the lower right.